Hey guys, it's me, Jeremy. Today I have a very, very, very exciting interview ahead of me. Jeff Benjamin.
Yes.
He's the first international K-pop columnist who wrote, actually the BTS column is one of his very first columns. So I would say he's the excavator of BTS to the international realm.
No, thank you. Thank you for saying that.
So I heard you were in Korea for this forum, Cultural Communication Forum, hosted by the Korea Image Communication Institute. Mm-hmm. So that's awesome.
Yes, no, I had an amazing couple days. It was such a quick trip, but I felt so lucky to, because most of the time when I come for trips to Korea, it's very based around K-pop and meeting with artists and agencies. But this time, I got to see some new things. I got to go to museums and different headquarters and get to meet a lot of interesting different people, see a different take on Korea.
Tell me, what about BTS back in 2014? Did you find most interesting?
So you did your research. You remember that article, yes.
I know about you.
Yes, it really, I remember, you know, I will never forget it. It was the K-Con Festival, which is a very big K-pop festival in America.
Still going on.
Yes, still going on, bigger than ever. It was, it was a very good lineup. There were big idols like G-Dragon and Girls' Generation and IU, and the newest name on the bill was BTS. And I was like, okay, you know, I will look for BTS. You know, I knew they were very open to interviews. I saw fans with walking around in BTS merchandise. But the biggest point to me at that point was the fact that they got such a big response from the crowd at that moment. And if you go to that article in 2014, I think I said something along the lines of BTS might have been the newest artist on the lineup, but you wouldn't have expected it based on all the screams and all the yells of the crowd. And so I thought, I need to watch them. There's something deeper, there's something bigger going on there. And then since then, their music only got better. 2015 was such a breakthrough year for them in terms of the charts. The Most Beautiful Moment in Life Part 2 album was their first album to land on the Billboard 200 chart. And they got their first win, I think, in Korea with Most Beautiful Moment in Life Part 1. There were some really, really big moments for BTS in 2015, but I felt so lucky and special to be able to experience that in 2014. And
I guess back then you didn't have many like friends to actually like talk about this stuff, right?
It is true. I haven't had a lot of K-pop friends back in the day. These days, a lot more people are much more open to talking about K-pop, but it's been kind of a lonely interest for a while. But these days, a lot of people like K-pop, so I have a lot more friends to talk about it then. But back then, it was just me and the people on Twitter and Instagram. So thank you to everyone on Twitter who said hi.
People like to compare BTS to the Beatles.
You know, of course, we can look at BTS and the Beatles strictly by the charts. And yes, they actually were the first group, pop group, to send 3 albums to number 1 in less than a year, which was a feat only the Beatles were able to do before that. And the other group to do that was the Monkees, another very influential group in America. But the point that is so much more interesting to me around the Beatles and BTS is the idea of what they represented to the music scene. When the Beatles first came out in their era, they were not the trend. They had long hair, they wore boots, they wore, you know, long coats. They were very different than the Beach Boys, who were very much the trend. They were California boys, very clean cut, very nice short haircuts, tan, you know, very easy, fun to sing along to songs. But obviously the Beatles made such an impact and changed the whole way we think about music. And that's how I kind of think of BTS. It's actually something me and my mom talked about. My mom was a huge Beatles fan and watched the Beatles from their beginning stages. And that's the thing that she also noticed. She said, you're right, it is like that too. And it's something we've actually been able to discuss.
Well, I did some research on your mom too.
Mom, are you watching?
And about the music, I want to talk about the recent music by BTS.
Yeah.
Of course, Boy With Love and other recent songs.
of course, you know, something I talked about in my initial review and kind of looking at the larger career scope of what Map of the Soul persona represented was that, you know, it's kind of like a response to their 2014 albums and kind of some messages that they had earlier on in their careers. Recently had this idea that a lot of artists probably wouldn't want to revisit their music from 5 years ago, you know? Like, most artists are like, I did that, I was younger, it doesn't, you know, it doesn't. But the fact that BTS went back 5 years and looked back on the messages and themes and what was happening in their lives 5 years ago, and then took that to 2019 and revealed it and kind of talked about their changes then, that's not to be taken lightly. That's pretty remarkable, actually.
Koreans, and especially the older generation, still wants to know. They still have this question, why do ARMY love BTS so much? Well, okay, let's be real. In real time terms.
Okay. You can be a fan of someone's music, you can be a fan of their performance, whatever it might be, but the real people who really dedicate themselves to you, who really are your fan, your ARMY member, are the people who love you as people. And BTS themselves have always been very open about their human sides on their music, you know, of course, talking about things that I wasn't seeing a lot of, not even just K-pop artists, but pop artists in general, talking about, you know, their mental health issues, anxieties, school bullying, politics, things that aren't maybe the sexiest topics to talk about in pop music, but very important and very real to what a lot of people are going through.
Will Korea continue to yield K-pop stars like BTS?
Well, actually, RM is one of the few artists, we did a phone interview, I think it was for the Love Yourself Her album, and he's one of the few artists who actually greeted me first on the phone before I greeted him. He was like, you know, we got on the phone, he's like, Jeff! And I was like, RM, you know, like I was almost taken aback because most of the time it's a publicist saying, oh, hi, you know, I have this, you know, person, you know, here we go. Oh. And so many international fans in particular, we noticed this very formal, very clean, very sanitized way that K-pop idols do present themselves, and it almost feels like it's tougher to get to know them as people. And to a lot of people around the world, we're more connected with the people who do show their hardships, their scars, the things that you know, get them excited but also make them hurt. You know, we also want to know, what are you passionate about? What's inspiring you? Show who you are, show who you, and you know, of course it's going to be up to the agencies and the businesses to be able to say, we're okay letting our artists show more of ourselves. And I know it's scary, but I do think it will pay off in the end. Hello, 최가지. 여보세요. 사랑해. And 딱 좋아해. Don't forget to subscribe to Korea Now! That's all the Korean I know, but subscribe to Korea Now to find lots more awesome Korea content, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.